this is a fitting send-off. This is, you know, it feels right. It feels, you know, like we're doing justice to what is not just a fantastic film, but a fantastic series.
Yeah. I mean, the fans here, I think, have been camped out for days in rain, hail, snow and blow.
They are the hardiest fans in the world. They are. There is nothing that will deter them. They're amazing.
Well, just tell us, what sort of a treat are we in for tonight in Deathly Hallows Part 2? It's the last Harry Potter. It's the first in 3D.
I've not seen it in 3D yet, so I can't comment on that. It is light years ahead of anything we have done in the past. It is so far and away the best film. Not just within the series, but it is standalone. It is a brilliant film. I think everyone will see that, and I'm really excited for people to see it.
Well, you know, I saw you when you were first announced to the world. I'm welling up here, honestly. And here we are at the very last one. We watched you grow on screen. We've watched you earn your acting chops. How do you feel you guys have, you know, are you at the top of your tree in this last one? Do you feel the acting has been really good?
For where we are? Yes, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, we will all go on and get better, I'm sure. But this is, I mean, I actually can't believe that part one and part two were made at the same time, because it's like, personally speaking, I it's like I'm a different actor in it. I mean, it's the only time I've watched a Harry Potter film and gone, yes, I'm pleased with my performance.
Well, Hogwarts is over. Where is Daniel Radcliffe weaving his magic now?
Well, I'm on Broadway at the moment, 8 times a week, apart from this week, when I've obviously come back to do the premiere. But yeah, 8 shows a week on Broadway at the moment in How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying, which is all singing, all dancing, musical comedy. And then next year, The Woman in Black comes out, which is a ghost story I filmed last year, and I think people are going to really like that. I think it's going to terrify people. It's going to be very, very good.
And you've flown on the red eye to be here. Is this a sort of a thank you to your dedicated fans that you've made it here?
Yeah, I think this and one other interview are the only ones I'm doing, because I can't do, because I've got to save my voice, I can't shout for an hour. But the main reason I wanted to come back was so I could sign and see everyone and say thank you.